here in Milwaukee. MLB The Show with a good one coming at you. It's the Colorado Rockies and the Milwaukee Brewers. One down. David Sharp up now for the Brewers. There's a swing and a drive. That one is back. Off the batter's eye and gone. A gigantic blast. Another one in his incredible season. It's 2-0. Chris, he's homered in back-to-back games now.
Yep, seeing the ball well, and he's got his timing locked in. He's looking pretty dangerous at the dish right now.
He came out of his shoes on that one, but managed to keep his mechanics.
He is a major topic of conversation, the rare two-way player at the big league level. It's pretty early on in his major league career, but it's driving. That's ripped, and this one could be extra bases. Around third. One run is in. The relay to the plate. He'll score. Two runs are in, and it's now a six-run lead.
Nicely done. Brings home two. Nice line drive to the pull side. Met it out front, but just stayed through it nice enough.
Here's a rocket out to left. Bouchard snags it for the second out.
Now back.
And welcome back to the ballpark. Digging in is the switch hitting outfielder, David Sharp. Freeland back to work. Now a screamer into the outfield. And puts the squeeze on that one. One down.
The bat. The shortstop.
Well, they win the opener at home. First game of the three-game series, and there's just such a good feeling if you're in your own ballpark, you're sleeping in your own bed, you're eating your clubhouse manager's food, everything's right in your world, and they played like it today.
Now it's the switch hitting outfielder, David Sharp. He's a guy who does it all. With the lack of contact in today's game, this guy hits for contact, so he delivers average, but there's on-base slugging, too. And that's a base hit. Throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
Well, clearly he was ready to hit right there. Just a solid swing.
Warning track. And you can touch them all, baseball man. He made him pay for that one. He's not going to get cheated up there.
No, he's not. He's looking to do damage with every swing he takes.
Base hit. That was smoked through the infield. And that keeps the inning going. And his hot hitting continues.
They kept him in the yard that time, but all these.
David Sharp up now for the Brewers. He's already homered in this game. Drilled out towards left center field. That's well struck. That one carrying. And forget it. Now for Milwaukee, David Sharp. He's got a couple homers already, so can he possibly do it again?
Come on, man. Of course he can. Those two he hit were legit, and he looks pretty locked in right now at the dip.
Oh, and this one's blasted. High and deep. It's on its way. Out of here. Ball game. A towering shot. And the Brewers walk it off for the win.
Is the kind of thing you dream about growing up. You're in the backyard, you're creating the most pressure-packed scenario, and what do? You come through with the big swing. Well, he was living a childhood moment right there. Nice swing of the bat, nice win for the team.
Sharp with a game to remember, particularly walking it off for the win. So two down, now it's the right fielder, David Sharp.
Great.
ground ball up the middle. A sliding play at short. Over to first. It's there, and that's a great play. Ball to right center. Blackman going after it. Brings it in. Runner tagging and heading for home. It's a sack fly as he comes across to score, and they lead by two.
Well, he's always capable of losing one.
Out towards right center. That's well struck.
You're going.
And that one hops the wall. Rounds third, headed for the plate. The relay. Safe.
Well, here we are, third time.
Base is empty, one away. Digging in, David Sharp, one for two. And that one is lifted in the air.
Come on, go.
And that should be extra bases.
Now that one, that's your job.
Next for Milwaukee, David Sharp. Outfield playing very deep, not wanting anything over their heads.
Now we got two.
That's hard hit in the line. Bouchard makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. Brewers strand a couple as they hold on to a 4-1 lead.
Nice three-game home series sweep. They came out and, you know, from the first game of this series, really had a determination to
fly, let me in your house, a pleasure. From the knuckle swatch, shadow boxes catching black eye blue.
I play the thief, what?
This opportunity is once in a life.
So up next, David Sharp.
Yeah. Come on, big guy, hey now.
Now a fly ball to right center. Soler makes the catch, and that is that. Now the left fielder, Austin Slater. When the season is over, he'll set a new career high for runs scored. And that one fouled off. Deal two. Got him swinging for the strikeout. The high heat, too much on that one.
With that kind of velocity, an elevated fastball, even if it's still in the strike zone, can be tough for hitters to get on top of.
Nick Madrigal now at the plate as he swings through strike one. One out, base is empty. Up to the left into foul ground, puts it away for the out. Two outs, base is empty. JP Crawford, the next Giant to hit, and a swing and a miss there.
For whatever reasons, this is a hitter that performs better in night games. We'll see what he brings in this one.
Swing and a miss. He was late. Strike two.
Two really good back-to-back sliders. Now in an 0-2 count. He's feeling real confident about finishing this hitter off. He can go anywhere he wants.
Two down, nobody on. Right through there, got him. And it's a 1-2-3 inning. Giants go down quietly, scoreless after one. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Jorge Soler up at the plate. Sharp back to work. Soler, multi-time All-Star, batting in the cleanup spot, and he was born in Cuba. The wind and the pitch.
Love to see it. Power versus power right there.
Here comes a pitch. Swings and misses. Struck him out.
Well, he's got great strikeout stuff on the mound, doesn't he? I mean, double-digit strikeouts in his last start, and he's just racking them up again in this one. This guy can really dominate a game out there. Not a fun assignment for any lineup.
No score here in the second. Got him looking, and he didn't like the call.
Well, he's really dialed in, and this offense is going to have to do something to try to break that rhythm. Maybe it's square around the bond, step out of the box, agitate him a little bit. Do something that just changes what's happening right now, because at this pace, it's going to be a long game, so you got to figure it out quickly.
Matt Chapman stands in now and watches strike one. Bowling two down. And they'll do it again. Two outs, base is empty. Hits and misses. It's a strikeout. And welcome back to the ballpark. Set for the bottom of the third. And digging in for San Francisco, Tom Murphy. Swing and a miss at 100 miles an hour. Strike two.
No ball. Two strikes.
Got him swinging. Well, that'll boost the swing and miss rate, Singy. Blew him away on three pitches. He didn't have a chance.
Yeah, Boog, a dominant strikeout for sure. And he just looked overmatched at the plate. You know, as a hitter, when you swing and miss three times in a row, you feel like you've got a hole in your bat. You definitely start to question yourself.
One down, base is empty. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout.
Quite the start to this game on the mound. Looking very dangerous to these hitters. Seven punch-outs already, so this lineup hasn't had much success. Trying to figure him out. I'm impressed with what we're seeing here.
Swing and a miss as he was out front that time. Got him! And how about that? It's an immaculate inning. And we're back. And now, David Sharp. Webb back to work. And a base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
He's been swinging it really well.
Back here at Oracle Park, Austin Slater stands in. That one fouled off. A wide to kick the pitch. And he deals. Swing and a miss. Struck him out.
Definitely made him chase a little bit out of the zone right there. I don't think that's a strike if he takes it. Pretty textbook pitching. Get ahead in the count. Get the guy in the box on his heels. And then force him to chase your pitch where he doesn't have much of a chance to do any damage.
And a foul ball. The Brewers up by two. We're here at the bottom of the fourth. Him looking, that's a strikeout.
Pretty electric stuff showing up on the mound right now. I mean, in the double digit strikeouts, he should be able to rack up some more before he's done in this one. And not many of these hitters have had much of an answer for what he's offering out there.
And a foul ball. That one off the mark. Going to count one and two.
Looked like you got a little excited on that fastball. Got to think to yourself, you want to stay up the middle. That way, if you're a little bit early, you hit it out of the ballpark, you're a little late, opposite field knock.
Cuts on it and misses. That's a strikeout. And that puts him just... Back here at San Francisco, bottom of the inning. Now it's the right fielder, Jorge Soler. And that's a strike.
0-1.
Out there, one down.
Well, they get the strike out there, and what kind of stood out to me was that they weren't shying away from contact. Every single pitch was in the strike zone, and that tells me they wanted to attack him, and it paid off.
Adames makes the grab, and there's two gone.
Up next, Johnny.
Now Matt Chapman at the plate. Went down on strikes his first time through. And a strike right through there. That one in triple digits. This one popped up on the move. But it's the pitcher that makes the play. That. Now a screamer into the outfield. Two away.
Man, he smoked that fastball. He's all over it. It's just frustrating when you can't get it to fall. Maybe next time off, he'll find a hole.
Swing and a foul over the screen and back out of play. Strike two.
No ball. Two strikes.
The pitch. Got him looking, and he did not like the call.
Well, that curveball had some pretty good break to it. As you can see, the hitter just locked up a little bit. Thought it was a great pitch to hit, but sometimes you're looking for something else and you can't pull the trigger.
The 0-1. Swing and a foul straight back. The 0-2. Got him looking. And there's two down. A big performance on the mound. Lots of strikeouts. That was number 14.
Yeah, clearly trusting his stuff in this one, Boo. Feeling really good about what he's working with, and that really allows a guy to attack hitters. You know, such an important mindset to have out there on the mound, especially when you're ahead in the count with two strikes.
Next pitch in for a strike, and it's 1-2. The wind of the pitch. And that just misses. The pitch. That one hit to right. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And welcome back to the ballpark. Set for the last half of the seventh. Now it's the Giants' leadoff hitter, Austin Slater. And now the lefty swings through that. Struck him out looking. Froze him with the heater at the knees. Here's Nick Madrigal. Swing and a miss. Right through there for a strike. The Giants hitless so far in the game.
The healthy cut, tough pitch at 98, but a really good pass at the ball.
The 0-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive. pitch. Up the middle. Safe at first as they can't make the play. So the perfect game bid comes to an end, and now we'll see what he's got left in the tank and how to play it on the mound moving forward. But Singy, he's been a lot of fun to watch in this one.
Yeah, Boog, really impressive from the very beginning. I mean, this guy was in total command the whole time, attacking hitters, and really he's made them look pretty lost up to this point.
And that's outside. Ball one. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout.
Simply said, this guy's flailing at the plate right now. Just disconnected from head to toes in terms of the sink of his body. That's his fifth strikeout of the series, and we're just two games in. So hoping to see some kind of adjustment out of him. His at-bats are just a little tough to watch right now.
Tying run at the plate. Fights that one away, and the count remains 0-2. The pitch.
Ball.
And a swing and a miss, and that's that. And we're back, bottom of the eighth, and now it's Wilmer Flores. That one finds the zone, and that's strike one. Pitch. Swings through it, and that's a strikeout.
Oh, there's a three-pitch strikeout. He can do whatever he wants with the baseball right now.
Chapman gets a piece there. The Giants down by a pair near the bottom half of the eighth inning. Comes up empty. That's strike two. And down on strikes. Chapman is gone.
Not the best location with the fastball on strike three, but when you're pumping high 90s, you'll get away with some of those, more margin for error. You know, the fastball has become such a huge strikeout pitch in the sport, and I think a lot of it has to do with all the attention and emphasis on improved spin rates. These fastballs are just exploding out of the pitcher's hands and jumping through the zone.
Out to short. Adames, the throw to first. Three up, three down. Next for the Brewers, David Sharp.
So clutch, you could argue that he's been this team's MVP this year.
That's a hit. Fires it to the plate, around third. Well, Singy, he is locked in there.
Well, he's really slowed the game down, and it's like,
bottom nine, and now the center fielder, Luis Montos. As he turns on the rubber, and with that good live arm delivers. And first offering is fouled off. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two. He goes down looking.
Well, I think that's a case of overthinking right there. He got three straight fastballs looking in the 0-2 count just to pour it back.
VR batting with one down, takes a strike. And it's quickly nothing and two on the designated hitter. That one missed.
Just missing off the plate there, according to the umpire. And out there on the mound, maybe trying to get an explanation. Can't say he's convinced, but it looks like he's accepted it.
The wind of the pitch. Can't connect on the curveball, struck him out.
Man, I really like the ability to bounce back right there after not getting a call he probably should have gotten. He didn't let it affect his focus, and he came back with another good pitch to get him swinging.
Slater stands in with two away as he takes a ball. The Brewers trying to close out a three-run lead here in the last half of inning number nine.
Game. Really incredible performance
performance on the mound, you know he's going to stew a little bit over that one hit that he gave up, because when you look at the body of work, so dominant, he'd have made just one better pitch. Perhaps he'd have a no-hitter.
For the Victoria Brewers, three runs, six hits, no errors, they left 9 runs on the base.
That's a base hit. Yelich flies around third. He scores and they have the lead. 1-0.
Well, there you go. The RBI machine. Another clutch.
Back here at Oracle Park, on to the third inning. Here's some real power at the plate. David Sharp. Base hit. That was smoked through the infield. Man aboard on the leadoff single. Well, Singy, he is locked in there.
Well, he's really slowed the game down, and it's like...
And a base hit. Runner around third. Here comes the throw. It's off the mark, and he scores. Well, he delivers in a huge... David Sharp, the next to hit.
And that one is lifted in the air, ranging into the alley. Can't get to it.
Waste no time there. To me,
here's the Brewers DH, David Sharp. 4-for-4 with 4 singles. And there's a hit. And that extends the inning.
Now batting, shortstop.
The number 7 is such a cool and sort of lucky number. Well, this team has been playing really well, but to win 7 games in a row, there's been some luck and there's been some really good play. I think you get to this